Well, now let's check in with our meteorologist, Autumn Robertson, who is following three new disturbances in the tropics tonight. Hey, Autumn.
Hey, Candace. Yeah, even though we are saying goodbye to Laura, we still have to say hello to three new waves that we've been monitoring over the past day or so. One has actually been aiding in the amount of rain that we saw earlier on today that could creep up along the eastern seaboard as we get into the next several days. And two disturbances still out in the Atlantic there could have a good chance of developing as we head into next week. Right now, none of these areas have a solid chance of developing, within the next day or two, still a low chance over the next day or 2 days or into 5 days. So heading into next week, there's actually a better chance of development for each system. This one I was just talking about, we did see a good bit of a shower activity and storm activity. We're still seeing that tonight. And we can see that disturbance creep up the southeastern coast there and then make its way out into the Atlantic as we get into next week. The other two disturbances, one closer to the coast of Africa there, has a slightly better chance of developing as we head into next week compared to the other one that's closer to the Leeward Islands this evening. But still, good areas to watch. They could head into more favorable environments as we get into next week. So definitely some action there in the tropics, and we could see potential storms over the next several days here. The next storm is Nana, and we are already really blazing through this list here. We only have a few more names to go until we have to start using Greek letters. So we are blazing through the hurricane season, and we could see potentially new developments as we head into next week.